Okay, as promised, I'm working on my build video before I start taking everything apart and working on the hexacopter installing these. I guess it's a good idea to make sure that they work. So here we go. I've got it hooked up to a servo tester, and right now they are in the up position. And now they're in the down position, so everything appears to be working good. I did notice that up inside it is definitely you can see up through in there here. You probably can't see it on the video, but it is plastic gears. So that's could be a minor flaw, but I mean if everything works good on them, and if you can get replacement servos for them really cheap, that may not be too bad. But they do sound really good, and they seem to be locked in place pretty well too. Okay, here's my Flame Wheel F550, and it is fully loaded. I mean, we have the DJI ground station, we have FPV, we've got on-screen display, and we got the Zen Moose brushless gimbal. Also have a light system on there, though that light system doesn't work too well, doesn't show up well during the day. But anyhow, like I said, it's fully loaded. So what I'm going to try to do is keep from drilling, having to drill any holes in the bottom of this, because then I'll have to take everything out in the center of it, and in order to do it without destroying anything. So I'm going to do some experimenting. And we'll go from there. First thing I'm going to do is take this top off, because that way I can set this off to the side and protect that GPS antenna. So off to the next step. Okay, what I have come up with that might we're going to see if it works. I've got some good servo tape here, and this stuff here I use it on a lot of my other components. It's double-sided tape, and once it adheres, it stays on there pretty good. And then I'm going to back it up with some tie wraps that I've got wrapped here, coming through the frame, and we'll put those through the center here, and that should hold her in place pretty good. That's what we're going to go with. Okay, I have it secured there, and I'm really liking what I see. So I mean, I get no movement at all on that, and it's pretty secured with that the servo tape that I put on the bottom, and then I've got two zip ties. I don't know if you can see it there, but you got two zip ties, one here, one there, going right over the servo. And it will still be out of the way of the arms altogether. Remember, folks, when you're working with multi-rotors, zip ties are your friend. Okay, this is what I've got so far. We've got this mounted in, the retracts mounted in place now. I took my 2.4 data link for my ground DJI ground station. I mounted that on the bottom. Put a little bit of hot glue on the bottom side of that, because I ran out of the servo tape when I put the landing gear on it. And just put across a zip tie there. And then zip tied my video transmitter. And so now what I want to do is we'll hook this back up to the servo tester again and put our landing gear on. One thing I also wanted to point out, though, is in the package they give you a little Allen screw, Allen wrench, and I noticed that it doesn't fit the screws for the landing gear. Well, I thought that was a bit strange. So then when I went to look at putting this on the landing gear, I noticed that it looked like I was missing two screws. So I went back over my unboxing video to see if anything fell out. I couldn't find anything. So I took this piece down to the local hardware store, hoping that I could be able to find some machine screws to fit that, which would be a long shot, because most of your hardware stores don't carry much of that or anything that small. But luckily they did have something in down there, and when I went to put it in the hole, I couldn't get it to go in the hole. And then I realized that those little hex head set screws in there. So those screws are already in there. So if you think you're missing some screws, take a closer look. You probably already have the set screws or locking screws already in place. So I just wanted to give that little bit of a tip there. And what we'll do is we'll go ahead and set this up, and we'll see the gears in operation on the next scene. As I'm putting these back on, or these landing gear in position, or mounting them on the servos, I should say, I'd like to point out that there is a flat spot that's located. It's not very big flat spot, but there is on the inboard side there is a flat spot for the set screws to set. So you make sure that you put those on that flat spot there, so you get a good seating. And we'll just leave the camera running as I'm doing this, and then we'll be able to do a test. Now see, my eyesight isn't the best, so if I lose one of these set screws, I might be in a world of hurt. So I'm going to try not to take them out of the... But so far, I'm pretty impressed with the craftsmanship on these for the price that you pay. But really, only time will tell. My F550 is a pretty heavy unit, so I hope it's not too heavy for what we've got here on the landing gear. I won't hold that against Horizon, or I almost said the competitor's name. I won't hold it against Hobby King if I do overload this, because that's my responsibility to make sure I'm not... make sure I'm using the equipment for what it's designed for. If I'm overloading it, then that's my fault. But okay, it might be easier for me to put the landing gear back down to do this. I think that's what we'll do. But no, that is nice and solid. I like that. So let's go ahead and we'll lower this one back down. I'm just using my servo tester again. Jerks a little bit, but anyhow, one more to put on here. Normally when I'm doing my how-to videos, I don't like to spend a lot of time doing individual steps, because everybody knows how to use a screwdriver, pliers, whatnot. I like to do just the important steps. Oh, well, let's bring that back up. Now we'll bring it back down. And tighten it up. I may even go back and put some Loctite on these individual nuts and bolts. May not be a bad idea also. Let me lower this one down just a little bit. That one sticks a little bit higher out than the other one, and it'll be sitting a little canny wampus, I guess is the word I'm looking for. Yeah, there you go. Make sure they're bottomed out. We're almost ready to flip it over. Here we go. They seem tight. I don't want to put too much pressure on it, just in case it breaks it. But so let's pop these off now. And flip it over. Pretty good. Now I gotta redo my wiring and everything else on the inside here, and I think we'll be all right. Sweet. Okay, we've got everything put back together, and I did have my AUX3 channel, which I've got them hooked up to as AUX3. That was the ones that I used for my lights. And since I very rarely fly at night, I just went ahead and took the lights off. But anyhow, let's see if we can get this in here while I activate my transmitter. There we go, that's up. And that's down. I like it, and they're good and solid. So it shouldn't have any problem handling the weight. So that's it. Next thing, they look like they might be a little bit pigeon-toed in the front, but that's not a big problem at all. I'm not sure if that helps with stability on the landings or not, but I'm not going to fuss about it too much. And then the other thing I'm going to do too is I'm going to look at doing some mixing on my transmitter, so that way when I hit the switch for return to home, it will automatically drop the landing gear. Now if you lose signal and it starts to come home and land, it's probably going to land on the gimbal. But I'll mess with it, and if I come up with a way for mixing it, and so when it defaults to down on return to home, then I'll post another video. But there you have it, my build video for these new Hobby King retracts. And from what I'm seeing, I like them so far. Only time will tell how well they stand up to the bouncing and landing and so forth. So thanks for watching.